Hello, wonderful women of God. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, wherever you're joining us from. This is the Travail of Hannah Interdenominational Women Meeting. We're glad that you're joining us this evening, and we know that you're going to be blessed. I'd like to take this opportunity to appreciate the leadership for the privilege to lead us in our opening prayer. Straight away, we will be praying a prayer of thanksgiving. And we will open our Bibles to the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse 15. 2 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse 15. And I read, "For all things are for your sakes, that the abundant grace of God might be through the thanksgiving of many abound to the glory of God." And we will go before the Lord in prayer and say, "Father, cause your hand, cause us to recognize and lift our voices in thanksgiving for the steady hand over our lives, the hand that neither sleeps nor slumbers, over our family, over our children, and over our marriages." Let's go before the Lord and appreciate Him. Father, we give you all the praise. We give you all honor. We acknowledge you, O Lord. We acknowledge your hand, O precious Father. We acknowledge your hand. The Bible says that grace abounds where there is thanksgiving. Lord, we come this evening to give you thanks, to give you thanks, to give you thanks, to give you thanks, give you thanks, O precious Father, for your hand that has constantly been upon our lives. Your hand over the lives of our children. Your hand over the lives of our family. Your hand over the work of our hands, Lord Jesus. We come to recognize that grace this evening, O Lord. We come to recognize that grace this evening. We are grateful for keeping us, for watching over us from the last meeting up until this meeting, Lord. We have come back to appreciate your precious King for the great things that you are writing in our lives, Lord Jesus. To you alone be all the praise. To you alone be all the glory. We give you all the praise, O Lord. We recognize your grace, O Lord, that it might be abundant in our lives. We recognize that grace. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have given thanks.
Amen.
We will go and pray for the presence of God, and we will be reading from the book of Jeremiah chapter 29 and verse 13. Jeremiah 29 and verse 13. And the Bible says, "And ye shall seek me and find me, when ye shall search for me with all your heart." Ye shall seek me and ye shall find me, when ye shall search for me with all your heart. We'll be going before the Lord and we'll say, "Lord, we seek and we desire your awesome presence in this service today, because it is your presence that makes for the difference." Let us open up our mouths and begin to pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we begin to pray for your presence, O Lord. Your presence that makes the difference. Your presence that makes for the difference, O Lord. We pray for your awesome presence, O Lord. We pray for your awesome presence. We pray for your awesome presence in this meeting. The Bible says that if those who watch over the city do so without God, they do it in vain. Precious Father, this evening we begin to call for your presence. We begin to call for your presence. It is your presence that makes the difference. Where two or three are gathered in your name, O Lord, in your name, your presence calls for the difference, O Lord. We call for the presence. Some presence to be with us and to go with us. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed.
Amen.
We will proceed to pray for the viewers, and we will be reading from the book of Joshua chapter 3 and verse 9. Joshua chapter 3 and verse 9. And I read, "And Joshua said unto the children of Israel, Come hither and hear the words of you of the Lord your God." Says Joshua said to the children of Israel, "Come hither and hear the words of the Lord your God." We will pray and we'll be asking God, Father, begin to gather your children to hear your word. From all corners of the earth, begin to gather them to hear your word. Gather them to hear your word. Let's open our voices and pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we begin to call forth for your children. We begin to call forth for your children. All the women, all the ladies, wherever they are, oh Lord, we begin to call them forth. We begin to call them forth. From all four corners of the earth, we begin to call them forth. We begin to call them forth, oh Lord. precious Father. Gather them. Gather them, O precious Lord, that they will hear the word that you have for them today. That the word that will minister to their lives, O Lord, will not elude them. That the word of restoration, the word that you have for them in this season, will not elude them. They will not be carried away by any sleep of death. They will not be carried away in going to and fro. But they will create time to pay attention to that which is important and that which is profitable. Begin to gather them, O Lord Jesus. Begin to gather them from the east, from the north, from the west, and from the south. We begin to call them forth in the mighty name of Jesus Christ that we have prayed. We will be going before the Lord and we will be praying for the word that will be coming forth. The Bible in the book of 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 16. 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 16. It says that all scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. The Bible also lets us know that the ear that hears reproof of life abides among the wise. We'll go before the Lord and we'll be saying, Lord, cause your sent word to come up. As your sent word comes forth, let it open me up to reproof. Let it open me up to correction. Let it open me up to instruction. Instruction is the life wire. As the word will be coming forth, cause it to open me up. Cause it to open me up. Let us go before the Lord and pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray for your word that is coming forth. We pray for your word that is coming forth, O precious Father. As your word comes forth, O Lord, cause it to open me up. To open me up, O Lord, to open me up, O precious Father, to reproof, to correction, to be able to make adjustments where I need to as a woman, to be able to make adjustments where I need to as a woman, to be able to make adjustments in raising my children, in my family, in my marriage, in the work of my hands, in everything that concerns me, O Lord, as the word shall be coming forth from the mouth of your servant, Lord. Cause it, O precious Father, to open me up, to open me up, to open me up. Instruction is the live wire. Minus instruction, we cannot be able to become distinct ladies. We cannot be able to become distinct women. Lord, cause your word that is coming forth to open me up, to open me up, to open me up. Open up my heart. Open up my eyes of understanding. To be able to hold on to that word. To be able to hold on to that word that is going to birth a definite change in my life. That is going to birth a definite change in my life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ that we have prayed.
Amen.
We'll be going forth to pray for the servant of God. The Bible says in Psalms chapter 105 and verse 42, it says that for he remembered his holy promise and Abraham his servant. He remembered his holy promise and Abraham his servant. We'll be going before the Lord and we'll be praying. Lord, remember your servant and put forth your words in her mouth. Remember your servant and put forth your words in her mouth. Let us open up our mouths and begin to pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we commit your servant before you this evening, O precious Father. We commit your servant before you, O precious Father. Remember the promise that you made to her when she was beginning the travail of Hannah. Lord, the word that you sent forth, O Lord, the word that you sent forth, remember it, O Lord, and put a word of the season in her mouth. Put a word of the season in her mouth. Put a word of the season. A timely word. A word of the hour, O precious Father. Put the word in her mouth, O Lord Jesus. Put the word. Remember her, O Lord, and put your words in her mouth. Put your words in her mouth, O Lord. Anoint her. Grant her unction, grant her utterance, O precious Father, that as you have put the word, O Lord, the grace to deliver it, the grace to deliver it, O Lord, the grace, O precious Father, to carry forth the word that you have for your people to fruition, that Lord, you will help her, that Lord, you will help her, you will grant her grace, you will grant her grace. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ that we have prayed.
Amen.
We have called upon him. Let us go before him and appreciate him because he is the God that answers prayers. Father, we give you all the praise. We honor and appreciate your holy name. Thank you, O precious Father. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
It's falling down. Healing rain is falling.
Thank you, Jesus.
Healing rain is falling down.
Healing rain.
Father, we exalt you, Jesus. We magnify you for the rain of your presence, for the rain of your presence. Oh, healing rain is falling down tonight. Father, we magnify you wherever you are. Begin to exalt his name, for healing rain is falling tonight. The rain of his word is pouring, is outpouring, is pouring down tonight. We'll be leaving this service soaked in his presence. We'll be leaving this service soaked in his word. We'll be leaving this service tonight, Travel of Hannah, refreshed in a way that we cannot even explain. Because the rain of his power is falling down already. Wherever you are, just go ahead and begin to speak in tongues as you welcome the Holy Spirit. Because the rain of his power is pouring down, is pouring down, is pouring down. Begin to connect yourself as you speak in tongues and you speak in the Spirit. The rain of the Spirit of God is pouring down. The rain of the Spirit of wisdom is pouring down. The rain of the Spirit of counsel is pouring down. The rain of the Spirit of might is pouring down. The rain of his anointing is pouring down. You can't afford to leave tonight, Travel of Hannah, empty. That vacuum that you have come with tonight, God will be set to fill it up. God is set to fill that vacuum in your life. God is set to fill that emptiness. The rain is falling. Gabuzi gadale kuzi brudusha yekete. The rain is falling. What you are simply doing tonight, you are positioning yourself just like we do when rain is falling. We bring out our containers. We bring out our buckets. We bring out our drums to collect the rainwater. I want you to bring yourself tonight before the Lord to water. Water. Don't allow it to be wasted. Don't allow the water of God to be wasted. Don't allow the rain of the Spirit, the rain of the Spirit of God, the rain of the power of God is falling. I don't know about you. I want to leave tonight meeting soaked in his anointing, soaked with his power, soaked in a dimension that I have never experienced before. Labro dozi kataye kekete kuria gabazante. The rain of the grace for intercession is already falling. Gamazi kekete karabo zabudu sheke kalabusi kata leka debushika mase kekete buria gadaba. Holy Spirit, I welcome you tonight. Take charge. Take priority. preeminence of tonight's meeting. Take charge of tonight's meeting. Drive tonight's meeting with your power. Drive tonight's meeting with your unction. Gabu zibri da kate kekete. According as you have ordained it to be, O God, so let it be. According as you have ordained it to be, so let it be. Thank you, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm so excited to get connected to you tonight, wherever you are watching from, whether here in Kenya, I don't know, wherever you are, all over the world, I'm sure wherever you are connected, and you want to partake of this rain tonight. It is my joy and privilege to bring you the word of God tonight. Praise the Lord. You are most welcome. We are glad to have Miriam Wethonga, Sister Samuela, Rowena, Teddy Opara, Miriam Kituka, you are welcome. Feva Nuru, Jenny, you are welcome. Annie Ben, Debbie Ochilo, you are welcome. Sister Tammy, Rachel, Jen Onkundi, Pastor Isaac, you are welcome. Sister Grace, you are welcome. You are all welcome. It is my joy having you tonight. Sister Lucy Acheng, Sister Lisa Diambo, you are welcome. Joy Mwenje, you are welcome. Praise the Lord. Like God's servant mentioned in one of the morning glory, he said with the new technology, this is one of the ways we give our welcome church. Hallelujah. In case I'm not able to mention your name, please be rest assured that it is my joy connecting with you tonight. Hallelujah. I'm not going to waste much time because we want to invest every second tonight. We want to invest into every minute tonight because God is set to do the unusual in our lives. I want you to shut down anything that will distract you because there is a word for someone here tonight. I don't want you to be here and there and then end up missing your own word. One thing I know, in a meeting like this, it doesn't matter the number of people that are connected. God is always very specific because we are engrafted in the palm of his hands. God knows us individually, and the same way our faces differ, that is how God designs and crafts out a particular word for each and every one of us. It is my prayer that when it is your own word, you will not get distracted. You'll be able to pick your word in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Tonight, I'll be sharing with us, before we go into the session of prayer, on the topic I caption, "The Earth Helped the Woman." I want you to repeat it with me and say it because you are a woman, and in case you are a man, say it after me. The earth helped me. Hallelujah. The earth helped the woman. And our text will be from the book of Revelation chapter 12, from verse 13 to 17. I would like to read this verse of scripture very, very quickly. Revelation chapter 12, from verse 13 to 17. And please do not forget, wherever you're watching us from, try and let us know where you're watching from. We'll highly appreciate that. I read from verse 13, Revelation chapter 12. "And when the dragon saw that he was cast out onto the earth, he persecuted the woman which brought forth the man-child. And to the woman were given two wings of a great eagle, that she might fly into the wilderness, into her place. Is now time and times and half a time from the face of the serpent. And the serpent cast out of his mouth water as a flood after the woman, that he might cause her to be carried away of the flood. And the earth helped the woman. And the earth opened her mouth and swallowed up the flood which the dragon cast out of his mouth. And the dragon was wroth with the woman and went to make war with the remnant of her seed, which kept the commandment of God and have the testimony of Christ." Hallelujah. If you look at this verse of scripture, let me begin picking them one by one as we move. Verse 13 says, and the dragon saw that he was cast onto the earth. When the dragon saw that he was cast onto the earth, he persecuted the woman which brought forth the man child. The dragon, the serpent, all of them represent the devil. The dragon and the serpent represent the devil and his demons. Out of all creatures of the earth, the dragon went on a pursuit after the woman. The Bible says when the dragon saw that he was casted out of the earth, you can imagine, out of all the creatures, I ask a question, why the woman and not the man? Knowing fully, the Bible described the woman as a personality of a weaker vessel. Out of all creatures, the dragon couldn't pursue a man. The dragon couldn't pursue a young man. The dragon went on a pursuit mission, on a pursued mission. Immediately he realized that he was casted to the earth. The Bible made us understand that the dragon began his mission. He pursued the woman. Let me give you an answer to the question. Why did the dragon pursue the woman out of all creatures? Why the woman? The dragon had perception. The dragon had an insight about the peculiar virtue that God endowed the woman with. The dragon discovered the ability, that ability of birthing new things that is in the woman. The dragon pursued the woman because the dragon was aware. He had insight about the quality, the unique quality, the unique virtue that God endowed a woman with. That virtue of birthing destinies. That virtue of birthing new things. The dragon saw the virtue in a woman. So the dragon went out vehemently with a mission to pursue in order to distract the woman, in order to disrupt the woman, in order to make sure he scares the woman so that she doesn't attempt, so that there will be no further attempt in the woman to bring forth anything. The dragon pursued the woman so that he can destabilize the woman, to disposition the woman, to take her out of her spiritual birthing posture. He came to push her out. He came to scare her. He came, he pursued her with the intention to dislodge her, to disorganize the woman, to frustrate the woman. Because he had an insight, he perceived and he saw the unique potential of birthing destinies that God put in a woman. Permit me to say here that there is still a huge level of distraction among women, which is as a result of the effect of the pursuit of the dragon after the woman. There has been a huge level of distraction. It is so huge that it has led to fewer number of women that are still active, that are still able to maintain their spiritual bathing posture. The dragon caused a major distraction for the woman. And this distraction has caused a drastic drop on the number of women that are still able to maintain the spiritual bathing position. But something happened to this woman that I would like to draw our attention to tonight. The Bible tells us in verse 14 of the same Revelation chapter 12, verse 14, the Bible says, and to the woman were given two wings of a great eagle. that she may fly into the wilderness, into her place where she is nourished for a time and times and a half a time from the face of a serpent. Something happened to this woman that I am praying tonight, that the Holy Ghost will open our eyes to be able to see it and to be able to understand it. The Bible says, and the woman was given two wings. She was given two wings of a great evil eagle. And I began to wonder why the wings of an eagle, not the wings of an ordinary bird. The Bible tells us that this woman that was being pursued by the dragon was given two wings of a great eagle. Not two wings of an ordinary bird, two wings of a great eagle. Spiritually, eagle symbolizes strength renewal. On that pursuit that ensued between the dragon and the woman, you will agree with me, God knew that she was tired. The only way to rescue her from the dragon was to be given the two great wings of the great eagle for great strength. Not two wings of an ordinary bird, but two wings of a great eagle. And like I said, spiritually, the eagle is a symbol of strength renewal. Praise the Lord. In the book of Isaiah chapter 40 and verse 31, the Bible says, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. Spiritually, eagles means strength renewal. They shall mount up wings as eagles. They shall run no matter what is pursuing them, no matter who is pursuing them, no matter the gravity, no matter the strength behind the force pursuing them. When the woman was given the wings of a great eagle, she was given this wing for the renewal of strength. The Bible says they shall run and they will not be weary. They shall walk and they shall not faint. I discovered based on my search that the wings of an eagle are broader. They are broad. And because they are broader, they can hold them up a longer time on the air. I also discover no other bird goes to the height of an eagle. No other bird. That is a unique characteristic of an eagle. There is no other bird that goes to the height of an eagle. So the woman was given the wings of a great eagle for great strength so that she can fly to an unreachable height. Hallelujah. A height where no serpent, you know, there are flying serpents. I saw it in the Bible. There are dragons that fly. God gave the great wings of an eagle so that she can fly beyond. She can fly to an unreachable height, to a place where the dragon will get frustrated, because when she fly to an unreachable height, not even the dragon could reach her, not even the dragon could harass her. Tonight I want to let you know that God is giving someone here the wings of the Spirit, the wings of the Spirit that will cause you to fly above every harassment, that will cause you to fly above every every life limitations that will cause you to fly above the billows of life. When God mounts on you the wings of this great evil, you become unreachable to the forces of affliction. The Bible says she was given the great wings of an eagle to fly to a height where the dragon can no longer reach her. To fly to a height where the dragon, instead of frustrating the woman, to fly to the height where the dragon will be frustrated. Listen to me. After tonight's meeting, whatever have pursued you will be frustrated, because your position is going to be changed in the name of Jesus Christ. God is giving you the wings of the Spirit. You have toiled around the city center enough. Every ordinary bird can be found in the city center. If God had given this woman the wings of an ordinary bird, the dragon will have caught up with her. Ordinary bird can be found in the city center. God is taking those wings of ordinary bird out of your life. God is fixing on each and every one of us the two great wings of the great eagle. Amen. The great wings of the great evil. Amen. The great wings of the great eagle. Amen. The great wings of the great eagle. Amen. What you couldn't do before, divine strength is coming upon you tonight. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Whatever have confined you on the same spot, you try to take one step to go up, it's like there is a force pulling you behind. God is mounting on you the two great wings of the great eagle, where you will be unreachable, where calamities of life will not touch you, where generational curses will not touch you. Whatever flows in your lineage, through your lineage, God is mounting on you the two great wings of the great eagle, where generational curses will not catch up with you, where generational limitation will lose its grip over your life and your destiny, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. If this woman was given two great wings, I don't know who you are, but I want to let you know tonight, God is giving you the wings of the Spirit. Amen. God is giving you the wings of the Spirit. Amen. You will no longer be found on the ground. Amen. You will no longer be found on the floor. Amen. What has trampled on you is over. Enough is enough tonight, because you are flying above the billows of life. You are flying above barrenness. You are flying above joblessness. Whatever have pursued you to limit you, to disfigure you, to discolor you, by these two great wings tonight, God by himself is decorating you. God by himself is decorating you. Whatever have scared you before, by these two great wings tonight, what have scared you will begin to scare you. Will begin to scare it. Amen. What has scared you, you will begin to be afraid of them. They will begin to be afraid of you. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Now listen, this woman was specifically instructed where she was to fly to after she was given the wings. There was a specific instruction. God will have me to give us specific instruction tonight where to fly to. When these two great wings are fixed on you, when these two great wings are fixed on you, there are places you are not permitted to be found. Because if you expose yourself to places, you become a prey again in the hands of the dragon. She was given a specific instruction where to fly to. In the same Revelation chapter 12 and verse 14, the Bible says, and the woman were given two wings of a great eagle, that she may fly into the wilderness. Hallelujah. Amen. Into the wilderness. She was to fly to the wilderness and not to the city center. The city center is too rowdy. The city center is too crowded. There is a lot of mess in the city center. The city center is where ordinary birds gather. The city center is where jealousy, where envy takes place. She was given a definite instruction where to fly to after she was given these great wings. She was asked to fly to the wilderness. And I began to wonder, wilderness of all places. But God is up to something. Wilderness is a quiet place. Wilderness is not a rowdy place. It is a quiet place. Wilderness is a place of rebranding. A place of rebranding. A place where God carry out a perfect rebranding, where the process of rebranding is carried out without much noise, without much complaint. She was asked to go to the wilderness, not the city center. I am speaking to someone here tonight. It is time for you to leave the city center, because God is unplugging every wing of an ordinary bird that you have carried over the years. You are not that special. God is fixing on you the wings of a great eagle, the wings of a great eagle, the wings of a great eagle, to fly to a specified destination. And that specified destination is wilderness. Like I said, wilderness is a quiet place. Wilderness is not a noisy place. Wilderness is a place of rebranding. Wilderness is a place of prayer. In the book of Luke chapter 5 verse 16, the Bible says, and he withdrew himself, talking about Jesus. He withdrew himself into the wilderness and prayed. He withdrew himself into the wilderness and prayed, talking about Jesus. Wilderness is a place of prayer. Wilderness is a place of rebranding. In the book of Luke chapter 1 verse 80, the Bible says, and the child grew and waxed strong in the wilderness, in the desert, until his day of showing forth. Wilderness is a place of prayer. And permit me to say, I wrote in my note, that one of the places, one of the safest place that God has prepared to hide women in this generation from the perpetual harassment of the dragon is in the wilderness. Remember, I said wilderness is a place of prayer. Anytime I mention wilderness, just look at the points I am giving, the explanation, the detailed explanation that I'm giving about wilderness. Wilderness is a place of rebranding. Wilderness is a quiet place. Wilderness is a place of prayer. And one of the safest places that God prepared for the end time women, the women of this generation, is wilderness. A place where they will be safe and secured. A place where they'll be delivered from the harassment of the dragon. Wilderness is a place of spiritual seclusion. A place of spiritual seclusion for the purpose of prayer, for the purpose of fasting, for the purpose of studying the word of God. It's a place of seclusion. A place of spiritual seclusion. Wilderness is a place of personal encounter with God. Wilderness is a place of intimate relationship where your quest to know God is so deep. The woman was given specific instruction to fly to the wilderness, a place of prayer, a place of quietness, a place of rebranding. And every attempt to mess the life of this woman after she was given the two wings was unsuccessful. And I say to someone tonight, after tonight's travel of Hannah, every attempt whether diabolically or whatsoever means, any attempt by anyone, by anything to harass you will be frustrated in the name of Jesus Christ. You will no more be found in the city center of life. You will no more be found. You will no more be found. There are things that cannot be conceived in the city center. There are certain things, there are certain spiritual conceptions that cannot take place in the city center because of the rowdiness of the city center, because of the noise of the city center, because of the harassment of the city center. Such conception takes place in the place of quietness, in the place of prayer, which is referred to in this scripture as wilderness. For the attempt by the dragon to frustrate this woman was unsuccessful. For the attempt by the dragon over your life and over your seed after tonight shall be unsuccessful in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. For the attempt by the dragon for any harassment shall backfire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. Now look at what happened. Verse 15 to 16 says, and the serpent went further and cast out of his mouth water as flood after the woman, that he may cause her to be carried away of the flood. And the earth helped the woman, and the earth opened her mouth and swallowed up the flood which the dragon had cast out of his mouth. Kaburia. You can't be in the place of prayer and the things God created work against you. You can't be in the wilderness when you find yourself eventually in the wilderness. Remember, wilderness is a place of quietness. It is a place of prayer. It is a place of rebranding. You can't be in the wilderness and the things that God creates not submit to you. She flew to the wilderness, a place where God prepared for her for spiritual nourishment. The Bible says the earth helped the woman. The earth helped the woman. That's why I know tonight, God, two things are happening to you. Two things are happening to me. God is fixing on us the wings of the spirit to fly above the height of the reach of the dragon. And the earth is helping the woman. The earth is helping someone here tonight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The earth helped the woman. Someone is receiving these two levels of help, the wings of the spirit, the wings of the spirit to leave the city center, to fly above the billows of life, to fly above the harassment of the dragon, harassment of life, to fly above every form of limitation, the wings of the spirit. And the earth is helping you tonight. You can't be in the place of prayer. You can't be in the wilderness and the earth not respond to you. Every button you press while in the wilderness must respond. The reason as to why some keys have not been responding is because you have been busy in the city center. But tonight, a divine repositioning is taking place in the realm of the spirit. Amen. Divine repositioning is taking place in the realm of the spirit. Amen. Divine repositioning is taking place in the realm of the spirit. Amen. Someone is leaving that rowdy place. Conception don't happen in the city center. Conception happens in the wilderness. Conception happens when you are alone with God. Conception happens when you are in the place of prayer. Your spiritual posture of birth becomes more comfortable when you are in the place of prayer, when you are in the wilderness, when you are in a quiet place. Two things are happening to us tonight. Number one, the wings of the spirit to fly above the billows of life. Number two, the earth is responding. You know, no matter where you are, you're standing on the earth. Right now, I'm standing on the earth. God decided to use what can be easily accessed to help the woman. Whether the rich, whether the poor, everyone have access to the earth. But the earth attend to you based on the position from which you are commanding the earth from. The earth responds to you. The earth hearkens to you based on the position where you are giving your command from. Hallelujah. In Isaiah chapter 60, verse 8, as we get set to pray, he said, who are these that fly as a cloud? Who are these that flies as a cloud? As God fixed these two great wings of eagle on you, who are these that fly? Nothing harasses the cloud. Nothing stops the cloud. Nothing pulls the cloud down. Who are these that fly as the cloud? That is how people will be so perplexed about you. Who is this that is flying despite COVID-19? Who is this woman that is flying? This, despite the effect of coronavirus, who is this that is flying? God is fixing these wings on us. These wings on us that will be able to fly above dragons, that will be able to fly to a height that we cannot be harassed, to a height that we cannot be touched, to a height where witches and wizards from your family cannot reach you. Praise the Lord. We'll be going ahead tonight. Before I pray, I want to give someone this opportunity. In case you are listening to me and you are not born again, these two great wings are given to those that are in relationship with God. You don't want to miss this opportunity tonight. I want you to repeat after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. I come to you today. I know you died for me. Jesus, wash me with your blood. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness. Today, I receive you into my life as my Lord and personal Savior. Thank you, Father, for accepting me, for it is in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Congratulations. In case you prayed this prayer and you are right now online, why not key in there and mention to us? Let us know that you are born again. Feel free and get in touch with me. There is a number there for further counseling. And if you wish to, and there is a Bible-believing church where you are, take yourself to the pastor for further counseling. Praise the Lord. We are going right away into the session of prayer. We'll be asking the Lord. The Bible says she was given two great wings. If this woman was given two great wings, it means we can also be given these two great wings. We'll be saying, Father, give me the two wings of the great eagle. Lord, give me the two wings of the great eagle. Go ahead and begin to ask the Lord. The Bible says, he that asks, receive. Give me the two great wings. Give me the two wings of the great eagle. Great eagle, Father, I ask tonight, give me, oh God, give me the two wings of the great eagle to fly above the billows of life. Give me the two wings of the great eagle. Lord, I desire these two wings tonight. Give me the two great wings. Give me the two great wings. Give me the two great wings. Some people have meddled around with the wings of ordinary birth. I want you to talk to God tonight. Give me the two wings. The two wings of the great eagle. Have you wondered why some people keep cycling on the same position? Keep cycling on the same position. They keep trying and trying and trying, but there is no stable progress. You need these two great wings to fly above every limitation. Ask the Lord vehemently. If this woman was given these two great wings, Father, I need these two great wings tonight. Give me these two great wings tonight. Give me these two great wings tonight. Give me these two great wings tonight. I have been confined enough. Declare it, you have been confined. That have not allowed spiritual conception. That have not allowed certain things to happen in your life. Go ahead and cry out to God. Why should you remain in the city center when there is a better place that God has prepared for you? Ask the Lord. Father, I need the great wings. I need the great wings tonight. I need the great wings tonight. I need these great wings tonight. Until you receive these great wings, you will never cease from crawling in life. Lord, I receive these great wings. Until you receive these great wings, your family will never cease from crawling until you receive these great wings. You will not cease crawling spiritually until you receive these great wings. Career-wise, you will be struggling and you're scrolling. You will keep crawling. You will keep crawling. People will be brought behind you in that organization. You will train them and they end up being positioned ahead of you. No more. Until you receive these two great wings, your position can never change. Your position can never change. Go ahead and cry for these two great wings. Until you receive these two great wings, your result in life will never change. Oh Lord, give me these two great wings. I desire the great wings. I desire these great wings. I receive the great wings of an eagle for strength to fly. I receive the great wings. Go ahead and pray. I receive the great wings of an eagle to fly. I receive the two great wings of an eagle for strength to fly. For strength to fly. For strength to fly. For strength to fly. I receive these two great wings for myself, for my children, for strength to fly. For strength to fly. I have needle enough in the city center. I receive these two great wings to fly to a height where nothing will harass me, to fly to a height where I will hear God clearly, to fly to a height where my spiritual birthing position will not be dislodged. I receive these two great wings tonight in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Go ahead and ask the Lord. I receive these two great wings to fly above the forces of degradation. The forces of degradation. I want you to pray this prayer with the whole of your heart. To fly above the forces of degradation. There are some of you, you keep dreaming, and where you keep seeing yourself is in a mud house in the village. You need to fly above that. You need to fly above that. Anytime you dream, is either you're seeing yourself in the primary school where you left many years ago. That is force of degradation. I need these wings, Lord, to fly above the forces of degradation. Somebody may say it is just a dream. Why can't you also dream seeing yourself in mansion? Why can't you dream seeing yourself, you know, driving a good car? Go ahead and begin to declare, I receive these wings to fly above the forces of degradation. The Bible says the path of the just man is as a shining light that shines more and more unto the perfect day. It is unscriptural to keep dreaming, and where you keep seeing yourself is either you are riding a bicycle or you are in a touch house. It is unscriptural. Receive the wings tonight. Receive the wings tonight. Receive the wings tonight. I receive these wings to fly above the forces of degradation. The forces of degradation. How can you be in the city and anytime you dream, you're seeing yourself in a thatch house in the village? I receive these wings. I receive these wings. I receive these wings to fly above the forces of degradation. One of the things that the Holy Ghost laid in my heart is to cry and fly above the forces of degradation. Up today and down tomorrow, no more. Up today and down tomorrow, no more. Above the forces of degradation, I fly above the forces of degradation. It is unscriptural. It is unscriptural. God does not degrade. You can see how he equipped this woman, how he prepared her, how he took her to a place that he prepared, how he repositioned her, how he transferred her, because God does not celebrate degradation. Cry unto God, Lord, I receive, I fly above the forces of degradation. By this wind, I fly above shame. Above shame, above shame. Degradation is associated with shame. Anytime you experience degradation, what follows after is shame. I fly above shame. I fly above shame. I fly above shame. I saw in the Bible in Psalms 34:5, the Bible says they look unto him and were lightened, and their faces were not ashamed. I fly above shame. The day you said yes to Jesus, since that day you have not looked at a herbalist. You have not looked onto a herbalist. They looked unto him and their faces were ashamed. And their faces were lightened and they were not ashamed. I fly above shame. I fly above shame. My family will not see shame. I will not see shame in my life. My children will not see shame. My husband will not see shame. I will not see shame over the work of my hands. I fly above shame. I fly above shame. Every cloud of shame gathering, by this prayer, it is scattered. By this prayer, it is scattered. Joel 20, chapter 2, verse 27 says, "And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, and that I am the Lord your God, and none else. And my people shall never be ashamed." My people shall never. Go ahead and begin to cry out. I fly above shame. As a single lady, tell the Lord, "I receive these wings tonight to fly above shame." To fly above shame. He said, "And my people shall never be ashamed." I fly above shame. I fly above shame. Rako zibaka teketa la brodo bashinta. I fly above shame. I will not see shame. I will not see shame. My children will not see shame. I fly above shame. I fly above shame. I can't have these wings and be ashamed. For my people shall never be ashamed. I fly above shame. I fly above shame. Mapeko zekata la kozika. I fly above shame in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We'll be praying that, Father, make every moment in the wilderness a time of spiritual nourishment for me. Remember, we said wilderness is a quiet place. It is a place of prayer. It is a place of rebranding. Until God rebrands you, you cannot reemerge. We'll be saying, Father, make every moment in the wilderness, because you have been mounted the wings already. You are on your way, flying to wilderness, flying to wilderness. Wilderness in this context is not a bush. Wilderness is a place of prayer. Wilderness is a place of spiritual encounter. We'll be saying, Father, let me make, Father, make every moment for me in the wilderness a time of spiritual nourishment, a time of spiritual nourishment. Go ahead and begin to pray. Lord, make it for me a time of spiritual nourishment. No more starvation. No more spiritual starvation in my life. Make it a time of spiritual nourishment. Make it a time of spiritual nourishment in the name of Jesus Christ. Make it a time of spiritual conception. You still have some things that you are to birth. Remember, I said something at the beginning, that the dragon was wroth and pursued the woman because he perceived, because he had insight of the unique potential that God gave woman. And that unique potential is the potential of birthing new things, potential of birthing destinies. We'll be saying, Father, as let every moment in the wilderness be a time of spiritual conception. Make it a time of spiritual conception of new things that I am meant to birth. Just like our faces differs, that is how also the things we are meant to birth differs. Lord, make the moment, make every moment for me while I obey and fly to the place that you have prepared for me. Where as I obey and fly to the place of nourishment, make every moment a time of spiritual conception, a time of spiritual conception. Please pray this prayer with the whole of your heart. Many women have ceased to conceive because they are in the city center. But tonight, the wings of the Spirit have been fixed. We have left the city center, that rowdy place, that noisy place, that carnal place. God have moved you out of there. Now begin to take advantage of the new position and ask the Lord, make it a place of spiritual conception for me. A place of spiritual conception. Things because destiny is waiting for you. You need to conceive new things. The things that are connected to my life, the things that I still need to birth, Lord, let my eyes see them. Let me conceive them. Let me conceive them. Let me nurture and let me bring forth. Let me see. Let me conceive. Let me nurture and let me bring forth. Make every moment in the wilderness a time of spiritual conception. Nobody remains barren in the wilderness. Nobody remains barren in the wilderness. The barrenness season, spiritual barrenness is over. Physical barrenness is over. Go ahead and ask the Lord. Make it a time. Make it a moment of spiritual conception of new things that I am meant to birth. New things that I'm meant to birth. There are some of you, you are to birth peace in homes. What you are to birth is peace in marriages. But you have not been able to do so. Now that the two wings have been fixed on you, go ahead and speak. Go ahead and declare. With these new wings, I bring forth. With these new wings, I bring forth. My position, my spiritual position of birthing is active again. My spiritual position of birthing new things is active again. Beginning from tonight, I will see. I will conceive and I will bring forth. I will see, I will conceive and I will bring forth. Rabo zika ba shakata brodo zikete lakru daba zekeketeku. I will see, I will conceive and I will bring forth. I will see, I will conceive and I will bring forth. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Please permit me, I've taken few of your minutes. We are now going to the next prayer. In Revelation chapter 12, verse 16, the Bible says, and the earth helped the woman. We'll be praying Jeremiah 22:29. Say, O earth, 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 hear the word of the Lord. What does the earth need to hear? The Bible says, the earth helped the woman. Wherever you are, like I mentioned, I'm standing on the earth. Where you're seated, I would like you to touch the earth. In case you're standing like me, hit the earth and declare, earth, oh earth, oh earth, help me. You can't walk against me. There is a command that has been given. There is an instruction that has been given. Oh earth, comply to the command given by the Lord and help me. Comply to the command given by the Lord and help me. Use your hand and hit the earth. Or you use your leg in case you are standing and declare, O earth, O ye earth, O ye earth, comply to the instruction. You can't walk against me. O ye earth, you can't walk against my seed. O ye earth, O ye earth, begin to help me like never before. Begin to help me like never before. O ye earth, favor me. O ye earth, favor me. O ye earth, favor me. Comply to the command given by the Lord. Comply to the command given by the Lord. Go ahead and declare. Comply and swallow every flood. Comply, earth, swallow every flood that is poured out with the intention to carry me away. Comply, swallow every flood. O ye earth, swallow the flood of divorce. O ye earth, swallow it. The flood of barrenness, O ye earth, swallow it. Gabuzika yekeke kuria gadaboshika. The flood of laboring and not seeing the commensurable result, O ye earth, swallow it. O ye earth, swallow it. The flood of generational curses, O ye earth, swallow it. O ye earth, swallow it. The flood of stagnation. O ye earth, swallow it. O ye earth, swallow it. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. In Revelation chapter 12, verse 17, he said, and the dragon was wroth. I don't know what is wrong with this dragon. He was wroth with the woman again, and he went to make war. After he pursued, and she flew to wilderness, he couldn't catch up with the woman. His poor water to swallow her, to catch. And her seed, he couldn't catch up with her. The earth helped her. He went further, the Bible says, and the dragon was wroth with the woman and went to make war with the remnant of the seed, which keep the commandment of God and have the testimony of Jesus Christ. We'll be praying. If he went to make war, we are in a warfare. We'll be declaring tonight, the battle over the destinies of my children is over tonight. The battle over the destinies of my children is over. Go ahead and begin to declare. The Bible says he went to make war with the remnant of her seed. The battle over the destiny of my children is over. Battle of looking for job after graduating is over. The battle over the destinies of my children is over tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. The battle over the marital destinies of our children is over tonight. The battle over their academic is over tonight. None of them will graduate and return home struggling, unemployed. The battle of looking for job after graduation is over. It's over. It's over. You didn't show these children any other God. From childhood, from conception, it is God that upheld them in our womb. It is God that upheld them. It is God that kept them. You didn't show them to any other God. You didn't show them to any magician. You didn't take them to any herbalist. I stand in agreement with as many that are praying tonight. The battle of the destiny of our children is over. It is over. It is over. It is over. It is over. We decree victory. We decree victory. We decree victory. Go ahead and declare victory over your children. Declare victory over your children. Declare victory over your children. Thank you, Father. Oh, hallelujah. Victory is established. Victory is established. Victory is established. Victory is established over your home. Victory is established. It is established. It is established. Thank you, Father. Over that relationship, victory is established. Over your health, victory is established. Thank you, covenant keeping God. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. Let's go ahead and give God all the glory tonight. Let's exalt his name. Let's honor his name. He is worthy of our praise. Faithful God, we thank you. Faithful God, we thank you. Someone in possession of the two great wings, give the Lord praise. Give the Lord praise. Give the Lord praise. I am no longer in possession of the wings of an ordinary bird. I am in possession of the wings of a great eagle for great strength. I am a strong woman. I am a strong woman. I am taking my position, my spiritual position of birthing new things. Wherever I might have stopped, whatever might have ceased, I have received strength tonight to bring forth, to bring forth. You have received strength tonight to bring forth. And I assure you, not long from now, you will share your testimony. May the Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord cause his face to shine continually upon your life. Please walk in the consciousness of who you are. You are in possession of two wings of a great eagle. Anytime you feel low in your spirit, find your way to the wilderness. You are in possession. The height you are is unreachable height by the dragon. Nothing will harass you anymore. Nothing will harass your marriage anymore. Nothing will harass your children anymore. Nothing will harass your children anymore. God has delivered you from the harassment of the dragon. Congratulations. May the Lord bless you. What a refreshing night it was. Thank you so much for connecting with us. May God give you your own testimony in Jesus' name. Please do not forget, you'll join me again on 27th of June. Our next meeting will be 27th of June, and it promises to be great in the presence of God. Hallelujah. Keep on praying along with us, and I assure you that God will not deny you a testimony in Jesus' mighty name. It is time to honor the Lord with our offering. It is time to give the Lord, to celebrate what God has done in our lives, to give him glory, to thank him. We cannot appreciate him enough. Package your offering, get prepared with your gadget to give your offering, to worship the Lord with your offering. And if you have done so, in the name of Jesus, thank you tonight. We glorify your name, O God, for that which you have done in our lives. Thank you for the two wings that you have fixed in our lives. The two wings of the great eagle, Lord Jesus. Our positions in the realm of the spirit has changed. And we know that even our result has changed. Receive these offerings from our hands and use it for the advancement of your kingdom. And in return, O God, bless every one of us. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. The Lord bless you. I want you to look at yourself and say, level don't change. Level don't change. Hallelujah. Level has changed. Hallelujah. Congratulations. I love you all. Remain blessed. Amen.